Where are we speaking from?
Allentown, Pennsylvania.
Oh, that's why we're early. And Charlie, you in Toronto?
No, farther east, so New Brunswick, Canada.
No, New Brunswick. Good stuff. I'm glad to have Canadian representation. I'm Julie and the Phantoms.
Where are you calling from?
I'm in Newmarket, Ontario.
Okay, cool. Oh, yeah, yeah, represent.
Yeah, yeah. I'm covering TIFF at the moment, and the films tend to be pretty heavy. And it was such a bright spot in my week watching the series. It's just uplifting and positive and bouncy and colorful and musical. Thank you, guys. It's a treat.
Thank you.
This incredible voice. Really, rather, I mean, I haven't heard anything like that used the way you do. And I wonder, at what age did you discover that you had this instrument and want to do something with it?
It wasn't until around sixth grade that I actually started taking singing actually seriously. I started, you know, trying to get into everything that involved with just using my voice, school choir, church choir, musicals at school, anything that I could just really get my hands for on that was just affordable at the time. Because I didn't want my mom to spend money on, you know, an expensive vocal coach. So it was just really more about me finding my own voice and just kind of learning how to use it. But it wasn't until this gig that I actually realized that I actually had a good voice. I mean, like, I remember being in the studio and hearing, Flying Solo for the first time and be like, oh, wow, that's my voice. It's actually good. So, because, you know, everybody's always like, you know, you have an amazing voice and you never want to, like, you know, seem conceited. So you just kind of just like, you know, thank you. But actually being able to hear myself for the first time like that really just kind of blew me away and pushed me to even work even harder knowing that I could actually, you know, do it like that.
And I really like the fact that it's a pure kind of singing. You don't do a lot of gymnastics.
Right.
Cool. I love that. Now, Charlie, I went through some of your social media yesterday to check out this outdoorsman thing that I read about, and it's true. Here you are in Newfoundland, way up in mountains and the other side of the country. What does that give you? Something that you can take into your work?
I think it's something that I take into my life. So, you know, by doing that, comes into my work, but it's just like, I love being in nature. I mean, the amount of times that people are like, you're barefoot. I'm like, yeah, I want to feel the earth. Like, it's just, I don't know. Where we come from nature, and we live in a world where so many people are isolated from it. I think more people need to be connected to seeing how animals go. Like this morning, so we live where I'm in, we have like a lot of woods behind us. So, and we have beautiful apple trees on our property. And every morning there's this family of deers that come around, and it's a mom and her two little deers. And me and my mom like just sit down and watch them all day, just going around, walking around. And they used to be kind of scared, but they're not. And so it's just, I take it with me wherever I go. It's just the love for what the planet has given us, I guess.
No kidding. It's very grounding, I find. And, you know, you're lucky to have that. And to have that that love of nature, it's really key, I think. When I'm watching the show and I see that it's a very good show and I think, oh, there's going to be a season two, I wonder if you both, we'll start with you, Madison, feel sort of an ownership to your character and what happens?
Right. I mean, she's kind of like, you know, she's me. So anything that involves with her, you know, you always want, you know, just like you want your friends to do well. I mean, like just how Julie wants the guys to succeed and, you know, achieve their dreams is kind of the same for Julie. If you think about her as like just myself, as like if I think about her as just Madison, you know, I really want her to, you know, continue to do well with the guys and, you know, become that band that they all want to be, because you can see that they're working hard for it, just like we are as actresses and actors and musicians to get there as well. So, you know, we see ourselves in them and we are them, you know, we're Julie and the Phantoms. I like to say that a lot because I truly think that we're our characters, you know. It's like, it's hard to say that Julie is her own person because we're so like them. And that's where Kenny's casting comes in and how good he was at casting all of us.
That's interesting. So,
well, can I add to that? It's like when, like,
yes,
the way the Madison thing, it's like, and Natalie and Jason, who like the casting directors for it, it's what's so weird is I didn't know, we knew, we felt something like between us, but I didn't know how close we were going to be and how much, how best friends we were going to be, like just a few weeks into the process. And Kenny's like, no, I saw that since day one, the way you guys interacted, the way you guys communicated before and after the scenes and during the scenes. And it's a testament to who he is and what he does. And because he put like really cool people together, like really fun. I mean, I'm not calling myself cool, but I'm just saying I really love my friends. You know?
You're cool, Charlie. Stop it.
You're both cool. Both cool. That's a great answer. And so what did you learn from him in terms of the nuts and bolts of performing and acting? Madison?
And from Kenny?
From Kenny?
I mean, you know, he constantly helped me get into the mindset for certain scenes. Mm-hmm. And the biggest thing that I just kind of learned from him was just, you know, motivating yourself and pushing yourself and knowing that just because you can't do something now doesn't mean that you can't do it later. That was the biggest thing for boot camp. You know, I started off and, you know, I had, you know, enough skills to give me the role, but now I wanted more skills to just kind of get the show to be the best that it could be. And, you know, it was hard at first, you know, it definitely when you had to figure out how to get comfortable with these new people and kind of be in a vulnerable state of where, like, you don't know any of this material. You kind of just have to be goofy and just go with it, because that's what Julie and the Phantoms are. They're just goofy. They're just friends, and they're able to be vulnerable in front of each other. So once we got through that, which Kenny helped us with a lot, we kind of knew that it was just better to better ourselves and just to push ourselves to be the best that we could be. And we just started pushing ourselves for him as well, because we knew how much this meant to him, and he meant so much to us that we just wanted to be the best that we could be for him.
That's so sweet. I've never heard an actor say that before. That's so sweet.
it comes from this man. Like, he encourages confidence. Kenny encourages bringing ideas to the table. He encourages being these little creative individuals that we all are. And it's like for me, on when we were starting off, I had to do 2 weeks of vocal rest because I blew up my voice just trying to sing these songs. And then all of my songs were all brought down so low. But because of this energy that he encourages, when we're in the studio, finally, I'd been singing for like a couple, a week or so again, and learned the songs again. But it's like, in the room, I was like, can I try something? Because that's something that Kenny would let you do. And so then we started singing off, and then I was starting to hit notes. And then the next day, Kenny's like, okay, we're putting the songs back up. We're doing Now or Never. We're putting it 5 steps up, right. We're bringing it up to what it used to be, all this kind of stuff. And that's because he wants us to be the best that we can. So we always want to be the best that we can because of him.
Yeah. I love it. I love it. That is absolutely amazing. Now, yeah. Do you have any word about a season 2? I actually went online and I saw the reviews are raves.
Yes, they're great, but we haven't heard anything yet. We're just kind of waiting.
Yeah, well, yes, that's cool. So what are you going to do in the next couple of months?
Hopefully start a boot camp for season 2. That's what we're hoping for.
Yeah. Like we've been rehearsing, especially for all the promo stuff, been rehearsing home. And, we filmed a few things that's going to be released soon. And so it's like, I think it's just continue practicing our craft. Like, we always hang out all the time anyways. And so we're developing skills for each other. Maddie's helping me with piano sometimes. I'm helping her with guitar some days. And which is kind of fun too, because it's just like some moments we're sitting there, we're like, oh my God, this is Julie and Luke right now that are just like... it feels like this. So it's so hang out, watch, and enjoy the feedback from
that's the, right. That is so great. So great. Well, thank you very much. And I'm never eating another hot dog. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank
Bye.
You so much.